which at the end had a message. And I want to start by saying that the situation in Tanzania for human rights defenders is very appalling, and there are so many examples that demonstrate that. And since I'm the only person from the country, I'll try to give my testimony, but very quickly, I'll mention about other events that have happened to human rights defenders in the country. As a representative of the doctors community, that was a civil organizations, and also a member of human rights defenders in Tanzania, I've been involved in many patients' welfare and also doctors' welfare since 2005. And with my involvement, I became a victim, and it was last year around June that was when I was abducted. And I was called to attend a meeting by a state house, Tanzania state house representative. And I was with a colleague from the doctors' organizations. And in the middle of the meeting, I was attacked, and I was abducted by five men, and with a car that had no plate numbers. And I was tortured over the whole night. They removed my front teeth, and actually they were crushing it one after another. They peeling the fingernails from the two thumbs and from the two big toes. And then I had severe crush of the whole bodies, and with severe elevations of toxins from the muscles that culminated to me ending in renal failure. And I was referred to South Africa, where I was treated for 2 months with dialysis. And thanks God, I managed to recover. But since then, this is the country where I've never been subjected to any inquiry regarding my abduction, the severe torture I had, and they dumped me in the forest in that event. And even the state house employee has never been questioned, has never been subjected to any inquiry, and his name is known. And he has never came to public since then to deny he has got no hands to it. The government has never allowed a free reporting of the event of abduction. And the newspaper that attempted to report the event was banned indefinitely. And till to date, the government is not ready for this issue to be investigated by any independent body from anywhere. That's what happened to me. But I think this is the country also, despite that it's known publicly that it has transparency and is the country of peace, the situation for human rights defenders is alarmed by intimidations. And here I'll give two examples of journalists. Last year, it was around September, there was a journalist, this was a reporter of the independent TV channels. This person was killed while he was trying to report a political rally, and a police officer was the person who fired a tear gas canister to him, and that ripped his bowel out. And he died at the incident. And authorities tried to fire some murder charges against the soldier who was involved. But until as I'm talking, the case has never made any progress. And today, 1 year after the killing of this journalist, the other police officers, where the videos and other pictures shows clearly their involvement in attacking this journalist, they have never been taken any charges. And actually the regional police commissioner has been promoted to police headquarters and is now the deputy commissioner of police. And around 6 months later, another incident happened, this again to a journalist. And this was the chairman of the Tanzania Editorial Forum. They lopped off the top of his right ring finger. They pierced his left eye, and currently has only one eye. And they removed all the teeth, the front teeth and the fingernails. And again, as I'm talking, we have suspensions of the newspapers, two daily newspapers that are trying to cover as much as things that are not in favor of the government interest. So I believe whatever events that is happening in Tanzania is intended to silence and to halt what the human rights defenders are doing in this country. And I would be happy to take this opportunity to call upon every human rights defender everywhere to condemn these actions and in a way to remind the government of Tanzania so that these people who have been involved should be brought to justice. Thank you very much.